God can love so much. So the salvation of man doesn't depend merely on the love of God, but by the man whether to accept that love or not. That's why yesterday I said, devotee is one who is seeking God. A disciple is one who commits to be with the master. That is a different stage. Unless we become a disciple, we cannot enjoy the holiness, the protection. Yes, Job chapter 21, they are like, verse 18, they are like a straw before the wind and like chaff that a storm carries away. Those who don't pray, those who don't move with the presence of God are blown out. No preservation. They say, God lays up one's iniquity for his children. Let him recompense him that he may know it. There is no forgiveness. When they move away deeply, deeply, and they are being destroyed. That's why in the book of Hebrews chapter 10 verse 26, knowing everything well, everything knowing the truth fully, if we sin willfully after we have received the knowledge of the truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice for sin. You go on sinning. See, no, you know the truth, but still you go on sin. The Bible says there is what an amount of sacrifice you make that cannot cover your sin. Because the enemy by that time will enter into you. The defile will take place. He will destroy the holiness. And he will take away all that the Lord has kept for you. Let's close our eyes for a minute. The enemy is roaring like a lion. All that he wants is you and your holiness. You are busy with your world. He will not bother you. But you moving around with the Lord, he cannot tolerate. And still, when you do the will of God, he will not tolerate. He will attack you. He will try to blame you. He will try to attack your business, attack your job, attack your family. So what you need to do? Constantly put the wall of fire around your children. Constantly put the wall around your people. Constantly do three things. Number one, take the blood of Jesus and apply on yourself and apply on everyone. Every day, put the blood on your doorpost. That's what the people of Israel did, that the evil could not enter into the house of the Israelites. The spirit of death is roaming around the world, but he will never enter where the blood of the Lamb is put on the doorpost. So every day, doorpost, household means, as we read in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 12, I and my household will serve the Lord, will pray to the Lord. As Mother Teresa says, the people, the house that prays together will stay together. So the first one is, keep the blood of Jesus. Second one is, life of prayer. Start to pray. Whatever may be your little trouble, whatever may be your little disturbance, when the evil comes and takes away the disturbance and makes it into problem, in the very first thought itself, you just surrender to God. That's what the Bible says in Psalm 55 verse 22. Place all your worries upon the Lord, and the Lord will sustain you. The Lord will not allow you to pass through destruction. He will preserve you. He will sustain you. He will strengthen you. Yes. 1 Peter 5:8. Your enemy is roaring like a lion. So whatever that is concerning you, whatever is affecting you, whatever is mattering to you, everything, even small thing, immediately make it into prayer and call upon the Lord. That's what we read in the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 6 onwards. Do not be worried about anything. Whatever may be, with thanksgiving, offer it to God. Suddenly, your child is shouting at you. Suddenly, you feel something is wrong with your wife, with your husband. Something you hear which affects you. Don't allow the spirit of depression or spirit of sadness to enter into you. Immediately, make it, thank you, Lord. You know everything, Lord. Don't allow the evil to put its root in you. The very first instance, as soon as you hear, make it into prayer. Lord, I surrender to you. You know, Lord, you know, you are my Father. Surrender it with a confession of your faith. You do always good for your children. I and my family belong to you, Lord. And nothing will happen to us as you will take care of us, O Lord. As we read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 63, verse 9, it is not the angel, it is not any human person, but the Lord himself will come with you and he will settle. Yes, Lord, I believe that. I hold on to Isaiah 63:9, that it is not the angel, it is not anybody, but you yourself will be with me, Lord, to handle this issue. I surrender to you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Like that, slowly, slowly, everything you make into prayer, and then the peace of Christ, which you can't even understand, will fill you, will take care of you, because you have not only surrendered your incidents or whatever matters to you to the Lord in prayer, but also you have confessed your faith that your God will take care of you. You have confessed the promises of the word of the Lord. And then the moment you speak, because Holy Spirit and the word of God both go hand in hand. The instrument the Holy Spirit uses is the word of God. The moment you use the word, the Holy Spirit comes to make it sure that is being fulfilled in your life. So without the word of God, Holy Spirit cannot come in. He was hovering around the water, just standing. The moment the word of God came, let there be light, Holy Spirit started to use the word and there came light. So the Holy Spirit and the word of God, the instrument of, that's why it is set in Ephesians 6:21, is written, the word of God is the sword of the Spirit. The word of God is the, so Ephesians 6:21. Yes. So we need to, not only we pray in faith, we also pray with the word of God and confess our faith in the Lord. And then the peace of Christ, which surpassing all our understanding, will cover our thoughts and our minds. Praise the Lord.
Praise.
My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.